You may be seated. 2 seconds, already crying. That's good. That's good. That's good. Dearly beloved, we've gathered together here in the sight of God to join together Jacob and Kylie in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate instituted by God in the time of creation for the well-being of mankind. It's safeguarded by the law of Moses, affirmed by the words of the prophets, and hallowed by the teachings of Jesus. Marriage is a union close and enduring, a relationship in which a man and woman forsake all others and become one flesh. This abiding union illustrates the holy relationship between Jesus Christ and his church. Marriage is therefore not to be entered into lightly, but reverently, soberly, and in the fear of God. I encourage you both to stand in the presence of God and to remember that covenant love alone will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. Let Christ be your example, and let the Apostle Paul be your teacher, who wrote, "Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but it rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things." Jacob, will you have Kylie to be your wedded wife? Oh, there's more. I know you will. There's more. All right. You just say "I will" after every line. You ready? To live together in the holy estate of matrimony. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Okay. Kylie, you look fantastic. Seriously, like an angel with the sun. It's great. Will you have Jacob to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right. Who gives this woman to be married?
My mother and I.
All right. This way. There you go. I almost always say at weddings, if you've heard me do a wedding, that this is the favorite part of my job. And today, I can tell you that it absolutely is. I've been blessed to get to fast and pray with Jacob as he was asking God if he should propose. I was able, with your family and our church family, to witness your proposal. Sort of a proposal. You kind of just cried and she said yes. And Katie and I have been honored and blessed to mentor you guys and to watch you grow. And now we're here. Jacob, earlier this week you left work and came to see me because you were overwhelmed with stress. And as we talked, I told you that when you were standing here and Kylie walked out those doors in that dress and you saw her, that everything else would fade and the stress would melt away. So in front of all of these people, I just want to verify, was I right?
Yes.
All right, then. Well, here's some more quick advice, then. Don't ever settle for a marriage that is anything less than extraordinary. Don't believe that love fades. Don't believe that that feeling you get when you saw her just now ever fades, because it shouldn't. My wife's here today. And you guys know that I love her more every single day. I was giddy this morning just watching her get ready for your wedding. The key to that kind of lofty goal, as you guys know, is not only keeping Christ at the center of your marriage, but also making sure you calibrate your life in a way that keeps you on mission for God together. From today forward, there is no Jacob, there is no Kylie. There's only Jacob Ann Kiley. No part of you isn't her. No part of you isn't him. Be best friends, be lovers, laugh together, share mission together, make choices together. When you start to struggle, ask for help, pray. Don't ever, ever settle for anything less than the best marriage in history, because you can have it. Jacob and Kiley are committed to that mission, to be together on mission for God, and they've chosen to signify that today in two very special ways. The first is by theoretically lighting a unity candle that keeps blowing out in the wind, but God knows you're trying to light it, that's okay. And that represents two becoming one. Secondly, they've chosen to share together in Holy Communion, kind of privately back here, to testify that their own relationship with God is first and central both today and throughout their marriage. So now he's going to come and sing a song, and they're going to join me at the back here.
Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside us. We cannot contain. Your love will surely confine us like blazing wildfire, singing your name. O God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have surrendered to your design. And may this offering stretch across the skies, and these hallelujahs be multiplied. O God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have surrendered to your design. And may this offering stretch across the skies, these hallelujahs be multiplied. These hallelujahs be multiplied. Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside us. We cannot contain. Your love will surely confine us like blazing wildfire, singing your name.
Do we have rings? Nah. Oh, I thought it was gone. All right. Jacob, place the ring on Kylie's left hand there. There you go. Right over that other one you gave her. Yep. Repeat after me. I, Jacob, before God, our friends and family, take you, Kiley.
Take you, Kiley.
to be my wedded wife,
to be my wedded wife,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
in plenty and in want,
in plenty and in want,
in joy and in sorrow,
in joy and in sorrow,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
yeah, to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
for as long as we both shall live,
as long as we both shall live,
and thereto,
and thereto,
I pledge you my faith.
Kylie,
placing the ring on Jacob's left hand, repeat after me. I, Kylie, before God, our friends and family,
before God, our friends and family,
take you, Jacob, to be my wedded husband,
to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
in plenty and in want,
in plenty and in want,
in joy and in sorrow,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
for as long as we both shall live,
and thereto I pledge you my faith. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jacob, guess what you get to do, man? Now, I know you've kissed her before, let's just be honest, but you've never kissed your wife before.
Never.
All right, man, go for it. Would you bow your heads in prayer with me? Lord, thanks so much for today, God. We pray blessing on Jacob and Kylie. We pray a fun time today as we continue to celebrate. Lord, thank you for this beautiful place, this beautiful day, beautiful couple. Lord, go before them, bless them, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I now present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jacob Perry.